You have a message from Adjutant Sophia.
No one ever looks quite the same in person as they do in my reports. And my reports of you have been exceptionally thorough. You have something I want. I'd like to negotiate. Phineas Wells is wanted by the board. I want to convince you to turn him in to us. He has a litany of charges against him. Vandalism, illegal experimentation, sedition. I could go on. Wells is a dangerous madman. His plan is going to endanger everyone. You're in contact with Wells. I want you to... Wells was our mistake. We failed to apprehend him for years. I'm sending you my access code. Contact me from Wells' terminal.
Adjutant Akande's call has been terminated. Will there be anything else, Captain? We are now in orbit above Byzantium, Captain.
Not so fast. All right, you're clear. The adjutant's expecting you. Go on through.
Our UDL security attendant is always prepared.
Move along.
Apologies for the wait. I was arranging my stationery.
I admit part of me expected you to stand by your old friend. For better or worse, Wells was responsible for putting you back on your feet. That said, he's also a wanted criminal. For information regarding his whereabouts, you are entitled to collect a reward from Percival. I understand you've infiltrated the Ministry. The things you discovered there must have been shocking, even disturbing. Halcyon is on the verge of a total systems collapse. The truth is ugly and difficult to accept, but we must accept the truth before we can move forward. Malnutrition is already a problem. Disease will come next, followed by starvation, followed by a breakdown of society, followed... I know this must come as a surprise to you.
What's in this for you? There's gotta be an angle. There always is for people like you.
I appreciate your skepticism, Dr. Fenhill, but I'm not doing this for any personal gain. My angle is the preservation of our colony by any means possible. Nothing more, and...
Is that why we were suffering plague in Edgewater? Malnutrition?
Yes, Miss Holcomb, we knew why. The colony itself is dying. The suffering you experienced in Edgewater, the disease, the starvation, will soon spread across Halcyon unless we act. I won't pretend the truth isn't damning. Yes, the colony is on the verge of collapse, but there is a way to save it. I'll answer however I can. The lifetime employment program is not. The program is logical. It's reasonable. It's. Byzantium is the beating heart of Ark. Help me execute the life. When you turned Phineas Wells over to me, I knew I could rely on you. And you deliver results. That. Do you know how many meetings I have to sit through? How many papers I have? I can't save this colony alone. When I first discovered the truth, I was shocked, even disgusted. But the more I thought about it, the more I realized we have become lazy and decadent. I've served the board long enough to understand its weaknesses. That's why I'm relying on you. We've already crossed the point of no return. The collapse has already begun. This is a permanent famine, Captain. A famine is a problem of logistics as well as marketing. I'm sure you remember Dr. Anton Crane. The solution is a temporary one. Before long, we need to talk about. You handed Edgewater over to a band of dissidents. I can't have this. Adelaide McDevitt and her people have no. Edgewater needs to go.
I get that you board types are all about efficiency, but isn't this a bit much?
I'm asking your captain to amputate a rotting limb from the cop.
Here.
Someone has to be. Now is not the time for half measures, Cap. You replaced a loyal, if hard-headed, town leader with a revolutionary. Adelaide's people have turned Edgewater into a hub of dissidents. These people are dangerous. They're going to be. Because right now you're the only person I can depend on. Halcyon is going to collapse while the board hems and haws and. I'm not asking you to be a murderer. I'm asking you to be a surgeon. Edgewater. Don't fool yourself. The dissidents occupying Edgewater are rebels harboring. Graham Bryant and his merry band of morons caused enough. No, allowing thousands of colonists to starve to death because we couldn't make one cold-blooded decision is insane.
You talk less like a human than mechanicals I've known.
I am responsible for every single human life in this colony. Steal your spine, Captain.
I won't. Don't make me choose between you and Edgewater, Cap.
I'm glad you can keep. Edgewater is beyond saving. We're going to have. You were in the Emerald Vale geothermal plant. Do you remember what? There was an accident at the Emerald Vale. In fact, Spacer's choice. The insurance claim has been locked in committee for. I'm arranging for a delivery of mechanicals to Edgewater. Once the mechanicals are finished cleaning out Edgewater, I'll need you. I would never ask you to walk into Edgewater and slaughter everyone with your own two hands. One last thing. Spacer's Choice sent a team of. I like you, Captain, but you're not worth that much paperwork. I prefer keeping our relationship strictly. Report back to me when the job's done.
Can we talk?
So we're really gonna do this? I've seen lots of crazy, Captain, but Phineas is in a class of his own. Do you really think he knows what he's doing? Sending us to skip the Hope into Teratu's orbit right under the board's nose? There's a sobering thought. I think this whole plan's insane. Speaking of, I get that Phineas thinks he's saving the colony, but what about you? Why risk your neck on this crazy scheme? Come on, Cap. Still, all this depends on the other Hope colonists. I'd settle for a bottle of whiskey and some lubricant. Well, whenever... The part with the Hope. Anything...
Something you need?
Adjutant Akande has instructed me to reward you for information leading to the arrest of Phineas. Quite so, sir.